when I look at the movement of the nuclei through the fungus, each of them fluorescing, it's like watching the headlights of millions of cars moving around in a city that you're viewing at night.
Welcome to the intersection of mathematics and biology, also known as mycofluidics.
My name is Marcus Roper. I'm a professor in the math department at UCLA, and I study fungal biology. Now, the particular thing that I focus on about fungi is mycofluidics. That's the study of how fungi move fluid around. You might think of a fungus as being a mushroom, but that's just one organ that the fungus makes. The fungus itself is a network of cells that could be growing under the soil or within the tissues of a plant or even of a person. So this is what the fungus looks like, growing in its petri dish.
While an animal cell contains just a single nucleus, fungi have millions and millions of nuclei, which perform many different functions. Two nuclei right next to each other could each be performing two completely different tasks, though how this is achieved is still a mystery. Some help to create proteins which become the raw materials that the fungus is made of, and in order to maintain healthy growth, the fungus must constantly push the nuclei and nutrient-rich fluid towards its expanding edges.
If you have a pool of millions of nuclei, that doesn't help you at all unless you have some way of organizing how those nuclei move around. These nuclei and these nutrients are moving on highways, fungal freeways, I guess you could call them. If you want to prevent congestion, you need to make sure that there's a fairly uniform flow of traffic on the road. And the fungus, it turns out, has very specific strategies for ensuring that the traffic is uniform. They involve what's called optimization with many, 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 many different variables.
The fungus has to optimize its network geometry. It has to decide which part of the network will be an interstate, which part will be a bypass, a secondary road, and so on. It also has to optimize the flow of traffic. Too many nuclei on the road, and it could get congested. Too few, and the network is not being fully utilized. Calculating the optimum for the whole network, however, is very complex mathematically.
What we're interested in doing is learning the strategies that the fungus has adopted and learned to solve those incredibly difficult math problems.
Marcus is able to track how the fungal networks solve these complex organizational problems by using a combination of high-speed cameras and lasers.
The fluorescence microscope uses ultraviolet light to stimulate a gene that we've spliced into this fungus that makes the nuclei within the fungus fluoresce green. They're really beautiful. Each of those nuclei has a purpose within the cell. And a lot of what we're trying to glean scientifically is what those purposes are, where the people within this microscopic city are going, and what their roles are within the city.
For Science Friday, I'm Christian Baker.